Hey everyone, I'm Yannis Christoulas and this is the fastest and easiest way to do the split for three reasons. One, this method is based on the results of 32 studies that I recently reviewed in one of my videos, so if you want all the scientific proof of everything that I'll be showing you, you can find it there. Two, despite the fact that I have a fairly stiff body, I have personally achieved all my flexibility goals by using this exact method. And three, I have tested this method over and over again in all of my clients and watched them achieve their goals and make their splits fast and without injuries. After watching this video, you will know exactly how to train for the split correctly and effectively. So let's jump into the video and see how you personally can do this. As I said, everything that I'll be showing you here is based on scientific proof that you can find on my flexibility science video. In this video, I will present a full flexibility session for the front split, but the method is exactly the same for the side split as well. You only change the exercises. Now let's start by showing you the map of your flexibility training session for the front split. The key factor to understanding this is that you don't just need the correct stretching exercises. The exercises are a small part of your training, and if you don't know exactly how to use them, you won't be successful. The other very important factors are the method that you're going to use, the duration of each stretch, the number of the sets that you must do for each exercise per session, the duration of rest between sets, and the number of sessions per week. These are the most important factors if you want to get results. It's too common to hear instructors talking about stretching exercises without talking about sets, repetitions, stretching duration per set, the method that they're using, and the number of sessions per week. In this video, we're going to see exactly how your flexibility training session should be for a front split. Nevertheless, selecting the correct exercises is the basis of a successful flexibility program, so let's see which exercises you should use. The main muscles that oppose you during a front split are the hamstring muscles on the leg that you position on the front, and on the other leg, the iliopsoas and rectus femoris. The best two exercises to stretch these different muscle groups are the standing hamstring stretch and the low lunge. The front split is actually the combination of these two exercises, so you'll be using it as your third exercise. Of course, there are many more exercises that could be beneficial, but they are far less effective than these three. My advice to you is to not try a bunch of different exercises. You don't need quantity, you only need quality. So the only three exercises that you need is the standing hamstring stretch, the low lunge, and your third exercise would be the front split itself. Some quick tips on every exercise. During the standing hamstring stretch, keep your hip in a 90 degree angle with your leg. Bend your back and feel the stretch behind your thigh. During the low lunge, extend your hips, keep your torso straight and feel the stretch on the front of your hips. And finally, during the split, make sure to start on a comfortable position with your torso straight. During the front split, there are two forces that oppose you, the stretch of the front leg and the stretch of the back leg. You must balance these two stretches by bending or extending your torso. If you feel the front leg muscles pulling you more, extend your torso until you feel the stretch also on the back leg. If you only feel the back leg stretching, bend your torso towards the front until you feel the stretch also on the front leg. Now that we know the exercises that we need to use, let's see about the other very important factors of your flexibility session, starting with the method. We're going to be using the Anderson method. In this method, you start with an easy pre-stretch of 10 to 20 seconds and then proceed with a developed stretch, which is the actual starting point of your set. As we saw on my flexibility science video, there are two different training regimes that can increase your flexibility fast. Both of them are built around the goal of reaching somewhere around 9 minutes of total stretching duration per week on every muscle group. The first one consists of 3 sets with a 30 second stretch, 1 minute rest between sets, and for a total of 6 sessions per week. while the second one consists of 3 sets with a 60-second stretch, 1 minute rest between sets, and for a total of 3 sessions per week. They are both equally effective and you can choose what best fits your schedule. I personally use the 60 seconds per set, but I have also trained my clients with the 30 seconds per set and saw some great results. Again guys, if you wanna know why these exact training regimes are the most effective in increasing flexibility, you can find the full explanation and all the science references on my flexibility science video. Now let's see how your flexibility session should look like from start to finish if you choose the training regime with the 60 seconds. Starting with your warm-up, it is common sense that you shouldn't go completely cold into a full stretch. If you don't train your flexibility at the end of your normal training, you should take the time to have a quick warm-up. What I personally do is a 5 to 10 minute low intensity physical activity to increase my temperature. After that, start with the standing hamstring stretch. Pre-stretch for 10 to 20 seconds and proceed to a developed stretch for 60 seconds. Complete 3 sets, alternating for each leg. You don't need to have additional rest between sets because the duration of each set on the one leg serves as a rest period for the other leg. Continue with the low lunge stretch in the exact same way. Pre-stretch for 10 to 20 seconds and proceed to a developed stretch for 60 seconds. Repeat that for 3 sets on each side. Finally, do the exact same thing on the front split. Use some kind of support to be able to stay straight and relaxed. Pre-stretch and proceed to a developed stretch for 3 sets on each leg. This is your full flexibility session, and in this case that we're using 60-second sets, you must repeat that 3 times per week. Now let me give you 3 more tips that will make you reach your goals faster. Breathing, foam rolling, and periodization. Always make sure that you gently breathe out during your stretch. Calm and slow breathing can help your muscles relax and decrease the activity of neural reflexes that oppose your stretch. Another thing that can help you is foam rolling. As I have previously presented in my video about foam rolling has a great acute effect on increasing range of motion. So if you feel very stiff at the start of your flexibility session or just want to boost your stretches, you can foam roll prior to the stretching exercises. Simply do a 30 seconds rollout of the targeted muscles for 1 to 2 sets just before you start your stretching exercises. For example, foam roll your hamstring before doing the standing hamstring stretch. This will put you on a better and deeper stretch right from the beginning of your session, which in turn will allow you to have higher intensity with less pain. And last, what about flexibility training and periodization? As I have mentioned in the past, when you try to get more flexible, you're not just making a quick pass from recovery exercises. You are training your flexibility, and this is an independent training session throughout your day. As a training procedure over the weeks, there should be a rest period of 3 to 5 days or a deload week where you will do 20 to 30% less of your typical training. This is also one of the reasons why many people stop seeing results after a long period of systematic stretching. I personally recommend to have a rest period of 1 week every 6 to 8 weeks of consistent flexibility training. So that was the video guys, I hope you found it helpful, and if you do, make sure to hit the like button. My next video regarding stretching will be on its effect on recovery. So does stretching reduce your soreness? You will soon see what science has to say about it. If you don't want to miss out on all the new Science Explained videos that are coming, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. See you next time!